It's not even in here. Oh.
Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe. They're so great.
So William is her father, right? Why? That was a weird question that we asked. And a weird answer that she gave. Like he wasn't her father? Is she a stepfather too? Oh my god, our journal.
Damn. This is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
Cronenberg medical supply. $8,587 overdue.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris.
Huh. Some kind of rewind thing there.
They gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use her shitty tube television.
Yeah. Well, it would be hard to see that all the way from her bed. And her medical equipment is in the way. We really couldn't bring the TV that close. Oh my god, we get to see what our statuses with all these people. Alyssa? We're in touch with Alyssa. Hey Max, it's a shame that you hang out with those people. I thought you were different. And then the next day, Alyssa, I saw you throw that TP at me. OMG, I was so not aiming at you, I swear. Don't do it again. So Alyssa doesn't like us because we're in the Vortex Club. Mom? Happy birthday, Maxine. We can't believe it's been 18 whole years since you were brought to us, XO. No answer. And then a couple weeks later, Maxine, this is your mom. We need to talk about some of your bills. Are you there? Yes, give me some time to answer. I can't just text in every class. Some teachers get super pissed when people use their phone. Well, we never answered her when she said happy birthday, unless we called her after that. Yes, because it's super rude. And please don't be so snippy. Sorry, long day of homework. You're not the only one, and that's why we're wondering if you need to spend so much. We want you to have everything you need, but your scholarship doesn't cover everything. You said I could use your credit card when I needed it. I only bought film, not a camera. Maybe it's time to go digital. I'll call you later, I have to go. Don't pout, love you. Hey, honey, I hope you didn't forget to water the plant we gave you, but don't drown it either. Mommy. Well, some things stay the same. Nathan? Oh my god, Nathan. Yo, yo, Max, you around? In the dark room, developing shots for the contest. Sweet. So no two whales for you. Not yet. I'll see you guys later, though. Peace out. We remember everything from the other timeline, right? We know who this guy is and what a psycho he is. Taylor. Max, thanks again for taking me to see my mom. I think she wants you for a daughter instead of me. I think not. Your mom is a badass, like you. Yeah, right. I cry like a bitch. So did I. You just didn't see me. It's okay to cry. It gets old. My stupid phone is about to die, so call me back. Victoria. Max, you busy girl? Avoiding homework, as usual. I told you I'd help you out. You never let me help. Crying face. Okay, drama, stop. And you help me by caring. She's actually nice to us? She's not even nice to her own friends. I do try. By the way, I scored that killer bud from you-know-who. FYI. Save me a bowl. Got a bounce. TTYL. Come by my room tonight. Max, are we cool? Oh, this is 2 days later. Just wanted to make sure since you walked away so fast. Nathan was worried too. If you want to talk, hit me up, okay? Love you. Max, if you're mad, just tell me, okay? Silence. So if you want to talk, my door is open. Love you. She's so nice to us. So I'm guessing, like, what's today? Maybe today is the 10th, and we woke up and we're like, holy crap, and we just decided to ignore Victoria because that's freaky that she's so nice to us and our friend. Who the hell knows what to do with that? Dad says, I have his very special 18th birthday. You're an adult now, but you're still our little girl. Check your account. Don't blow it all at once. Same message, I think. Chloe. Hello, Max. This is William. If you want to contact Chloe, you can use this number. She would love to hear from you. See you soon, I hope. Bye. That's on March 27th. And then August 11th. Hey, Chloe. Maxine here. I know it's been a while. I just wanted to let you know I'm going to Blackwell Academy now. I hope this is still your number. And she responds 2 minutes later. Max is back. Blackwell? That is so awesome. You rule. Best of all, we can hang again. So yes, this is still my number. Cool. I've got a buttload of homework, but we'll get together soon. Don't tease me. It's been too long. I know. I'll see you soon. Chibi type of face. Don't have any photos yet. Oh my god, we started off again on page 1 of 1. September 4th. So much to do. I wish I could slow down time, especially to register all the cool things that have happened since I'm back in Arcadia. Blackwell rules. September 21st. Yes, I'm older, and thanks to Vic and Nathan, I'm now a bit more fashionable, too. They surprised me with the most beautiful straw pork pie hat wrapped up for a cheeky style. I don't know what that is. Best birthday ever. Also, drunkest. I can't sleep. October 4th. Hey, dear diary, remember me? Busy Max. Busy, busy. Can't write now. Must shoot. Must live. Must befriend. Should rekindle with Chloe, too. But must vortex soon. Party time. I have to go upstairs and get Chloe's mess. Wow. We don't write in our journal nearly as much. She says she's shy, but she's pretty outgoing.
To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn car keys.
Really?
These whales are just a preview of the tornado to come. And the Prescott Foundation? Jesus.
Beached angels looking for the whales. Whereas the shores of Arcadia Bay once acted as a lovely gateway to the Pacific and beyond, now locals and tourists face the sad, surreal image of gray whales that inexplicably swam to land and to their doom. The whale pods were spotted early morning on Wednesday, October 9th, and within a few hours, at least half a dozen were dead or dying on the shore. Smartphone footage does not reveal any unusual ocean conditions or excessive pollution. Meanwhile, ecologists and marine biologists from across the country are carefully studying samples from the whales and environment. The Prescott Foundation has vowed to provide extra research funds given the local scope of this eco-mystery.
Rachel Amber is even missing in this reality. I guess I can't change everything.
Search for popular teen continues. Blackwell honor student Rachel Amber has not been seen for over 6 months, yet her family and friends have only intensified the search for the 19-year-old Arcadia Bay resident. Police and FBI have a few leads and little information in the case, which has caught the interest of national reality show Where Did They Go? The Amber family has offered a reward for any information leading to the whereabouts of their daughter. For more details, please contact help at findrachelamber.org instead of org. That's what we did.
This insurance is worthless.
All the .org websites are now .org because of what we did. We should be ashamed of ourselves.
No, I don't think Joyce's tips will cover all this.
They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills. That's terrible.
Dear Mr. Price, this letter is to notify you that you're in default of your payment obligations on your home loan account number 783. The current amount holds the amount of $12,000. Exactly. Payable by August 1st, 2013. This amount has been overdue since March 1st, 2009, and you have ignored multiple requests to make a payment or reconsolidate your debt. Unless the full amount of $12,000 is received within 15 days, we must begin the foreclosure process on your home. We have given you more than adequate notice on the issue, and we have no other options left. Bastonald Clamp Lenders. Well, adequate notice is fine, but if you don't have the money to do it, it doesn't help. I'll talk to him in a second.
No change to spare anymore. Now it's back to cookies.
Yeah, I'm not going to say it, and you just said it twice.
Choices of food coupon boss.
So maybe she's doing extreme couponing.
Ooh, wonderful. Just shoot me now.
Can't look at any of these pictures or anything.
They're drowning in debt. Just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit.
Happy credit card services? I don't think it's that happy. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Price, your joint account has been closed and is now 6 months overdue. Please send a check or money order for $3,458 payable to Happy Credit Card. I like how they round up, you know, or round down, round to the nearest dollar. Due to recent state and federal cuts, we regret to inform you that your health insurance no longer covers Chloe's physical rehab. We can reinstate Chloe at a standard rate of $12.50 per week. Holy crap. That's a lot of money. $12.50 a week.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before.
Could she have walked again? Well, she can't feel anything. So what's the rehab for? Garage sale, furniture, clothing, and kitchenware. So talk to poor William.
God damn, the bills never end.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
Chloe?
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me?
Is she mad at me for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed, but she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William? I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
Joyce.
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
Oh, I can't ask. About the crazy weather? Or the Prescott family?
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
She works there? So she doesn't work at the Two Whales. Rachel Amber.
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber?
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
And the crazy weather.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
It's us.
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
Okay, we're going back to the Paris trip. Why are we going to ask him about that? Let's ask about the room first.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. The insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys, financially.
These bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. Price is always right. Get it? No?
Mm-hmm. Paris trip.
So you finally made it to Paris.
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience, especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there, but that's not practical anymore. It's not fair, Max.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want. I definitely have to take a third job.
Damn. Can't imagine. Well, we don't have that room with all the surveillance equipment. Right. Chloe's room is upstairs. I just realized we came from downstairs. This is Chloe's room.
Chloe's door doesn't have a warning anymore.
Well, there's no one in it. Empty. Use it for some storage and stuff. Is this one of our letters?
Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation.
Dear Joyce, thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can only imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I am so sorry that I can't help you with a loan at this time. Like everybody else, I am underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and my best wishes. Love, Aunt Dorothy.
They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again.
Who knows, maybe she could if they could afford to bring her to the frickin' therapy.
Toys? I kinda wanna open this and see what's in here.
Why not open it? We can't.
Shoes. Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. I never heard much about William's brother.
Hi, Bill. Sorry for not staying in touch since the accident. Work has been piling up, and I'm being sent to Salt Lake City to oversee a new parking lot. You have to go where the work is these days. I wish I could have sent you a bigger check, but you know the story. Money is nobody's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe and Joyce for me. Hang in there, Billy. Your brother, Aaron? Yeah, Aaron. What do we call it? A spool table? Yeah, spool table. Take the load off, girl.
I'm still overwhelmed by this new reality.
Yeah, me too.
I feel so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this. I could give Chloe the choice of keeping William alive, but that would be cruel. But then I see that they're a family again, and who am I to judge?
Who are we to play God? Plus, if we somehow change it back, we're effectively killing William. This is why no human being can do anything like this, because it's way too much power, way too much responsibility, more than we can ever fathom. We're playing God now.
I guess we stopped growing up together.
Is that when the accident happened, around 05? So we're not clear on that.
At least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
Hmm.
A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
Huh? You never know. Chloe's old room. Can't open the windows and stuff?
Apparently, the only thing that hasn't changed is this view.
Hmm.
Oh, Max, it is so nice to have you around.
I'm like someone's in here with us. Scared me a little. More bills?
Oh, no.
Letters?
I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
From the spinal center. As we discussed last week, Chloe's respiratory system is showing signs of rapid weakening. This accounts for her recent anemia and loss of breath. As a doctor, I am committed to her well-being, but I want you to understand the reality that respiratory failure is common in people with severe spinal injuries. Your daughter is one of the bravest, strongest patients I've ever had, and I'm proud to be working with her. I just want you, as parents, to prepare for any and all possibility. I believe Chloe should also be made aware of her changing condition. If you would like to discuss this further, you have my contact information. Dr. Anton Fibes. Dr. Fibes? The abominable Dr. Fibes? Just gonna look through your drawers, don't bother me. Don't mind me anyway.
Joyce is already a supermom.
Supermom, lead the family, Dr. Bill.
Huh. Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner.
Now she smokes. The freaking bird didn't have anything to do with it, did it? Could you imagine that? That really is like a butterfly effect. The smallest thing you do, us letting the bird in the house, maybe flew into the car with...
It's good for Chloe to stay in touch with her friends.
Well, no, but that happened... No. That happened later on when we were 18. Not when we were kids.
Look at them. They have no idea what's in their future.
So this is the same. Only now it's on the dresser because she's still with William as opposed to him being dead. I think it was where? Outside in the hall?
William is trying so hard. He's still awesome.
Super dad, be the family hero.
That is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture.
Now we shall deign to speak with you.
Good morning, Max. Ah, you and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
Joyce, William, Chloe.
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max, you're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
I hope so.
I hope so. You guys do such an amazing job taking care of her.
We can only do so much, and she gets damn sick of her parents. That's why it's so important you came to spend time with her. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and she... Do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce. I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family. And we'll always be one. No matter what.
Oh my god, guys. Can't take much more of this. I don't want to cry in a let's play. Let's ask her about herself. How are you doing?
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie. It's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
Gotta ask about David Madsen. Watch, she doesn't even know him.
Do you know somebody named David Madsen? He, might hang out at the Two Wheels.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver.
Well, she does work there.
Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh, I was just curious.
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
Yeah, we really can't tell her the real reason is because, in the original timeline, William died in a car accident, and she got together with William Madsen, and they got married. Yeah, they got married as a wedding photo. Eco havoc.
So, what do you think is going on here with all of this eco havoc?
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly, I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
If we drove off somewhere else, would this stuff be happening there instead? You know, and started using our rewind powers and all that? A lot of work?
Plus, you guys have to work, too.
Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates.
Smoking both.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay. Stay away from his son, Nathan.
My pleasure. William?
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together again.
He's been such a hero through all this. Chloe and I, lucky to have him.
And is William still the same?
Is William still the same? After everything that's happened?
For better and for worse. But always for the better. I never thought I'd love a man so much I can't imagine life without him.
Yeah.
It sounds corny, I know.
You rule, Joyce.
Shit. Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
Aww.
I know. Things aren't as neat and tidy as they used to be. William and I can't believe how much you've grown.
Yeah, kinda did that. Grow it up and stuff.